on Bondi Rescue. What makes young girls cry and grown men weep? And lifeguard's grim discovery. A man can't move his arms or legs.
He's got no feeling at all.
And now, his chest.
Stops breathing. We're going to have to start doing CPR. So we need an ambulance here ASAP, mate.
Take me back to the sweet times, the hot nights. Everything is going to be all right in the summertime. Baby, in the summertime. And even if I have to wait till next year, I don't care. All I know is that I'll meet you there in the summertime.
Bondi's daily rituals begin. Dr. Pacific dispenses its soothing medicine. But out past the surf lurks a nasty surprise.
Come and jump in the back here. Yeah. Just jump in the back here, mate.
A man has collapsed after swimming the bay.
He's come out of the water. He's got like one of those triathlete wetsuits.
Need oxygen.
Not taking a hot shower, any.
Mate, he wants some oxygen. He's not
sure. The Bondi local may have suffered multiple blue bottle stings, but his reaction is unusually severe.
You been stung before?
Let's call it
again. I think I need to go to the hospital, man. Serious.
For the moment, just relax, mate.
Oxygen will help his breathing.
What's your name, dude?
Ruben.
Hot water's the best thing for it, if we can get you over the road.
Hot water can help neutralise toxins remaining on his skin. But toxins already in the body can cause excruciating pain in the glands. Yet it's Ruben's back that hurts most.
Ruben, my back is breaking.
Yeah, all right.
He's getting worse. Yeah, he's going
back. Lifeguards need to ascertain whether Ruben is suffering something else.
Are you allergic to bee stings or prawns or anything like that? All right. And you never had any anaphylactic problems before?
Okay, mate. I really need to go to hospital.
We've got an ambulance on the way.
Dino decides to administer the green whistle, a powerful analgesic.
Just breathe normally. Tetanus, you can keep it in your mouth.
It has little effect.
The ambulance will give you some more pain relief soon. Yeah, just try and relax. I know it sounds hard.
Paramedics are briefed on Ruben's baffling reaction.
It hurts so much.
I know. So we're going to get you some. Do you have some hot water here?
We've got a shower across the road. I wanted to get in there.
Have you just got
We can walk him or boil him across. I've got hot water. You want hot water?
And big breath in. A big breath in. In for your mouth. Keep going like that. I want 20 big breaths.
Finally, the pain relief takes effect.
You're looking much better, Ruben. Feeling better?
Oh, I guess it will bring you.
Quite often the case with blue bottles is people think they're going to die and they get themselves in such a state of shock that people can die from shock. So he was that bad that we had to treat him that way.
But as Ruben heads off to hospital for assessment, the culprits march closer to shore. Portuguese men of war, commonly known as blue bottles, are blown in by onshore winds. Their tentacles, meters long, are armed with tiny but powerful darts. Deadly to small fish, excruciating to humans.
Just attention, all the swimmers out in front. There are a few blue bottles starting to make their way in now. And if you do get stung, don't panic. Just have a fresh water shower located on the promenade and it should go away within about 30 minutes.
Just relax. Relax. I know. You've got to get it off.
You just got to sort of cater to each individual. That becomes tricky after there's, 50 or so just coming at you at once and you're trying to watch the water at the same time. It's just frustrating with blue bottles. They're just a punish.
Thousands are in the water. Being stung is a lottery.
A blue bottle swarm has hit Bondi, you could say.
Open your eye, try and open your eye for me. Like that one. I just want to see if there's any blue stuff in that. You're right. You've got it all out. It's just going to be like swollen. I'll give you some ice to put on it, but there's nothing for the pain.
Stung me in the arm first, and then I went to rub the water on my eyes.
Oh, you got it there. Yeah, if it gets worse and it starts to swell up and you can't see out of your eye, definitely just go straight to the hospital.
Cheers.
Despite warnings, swimmers take their chances.
It's pretty common now. We're pretty used to panic, especially for people that haven't been stung by a blue bottle before. It is quite scary. I mean, it's a pretty intense sort of pain, and when you look down, you've got these blue tentacles sort of wrapped around your limbs. It's not the best feeling in the world.
Aww. It'll be okay. It'll be okay.
Don't worry, you'll be fine. It's just a little sting. Okay? It's part of coming to Bondi. You meet the blue bottles.
Sometimes the best treatment is humour.
Hi, Ben. Grab the chainsaw. Grab the chainsaw.
We're just going to chop it off. Come in, yeah.
They recommended amputation, but they just said just keep doing what I'm doing, put ice and stuff on it, and yeah.
Millions of blue bottles washing in. One more. Hey, buddy, what's up?
Can we jump on here, sir?
What's up?
We need
There's a tent down there, red and yellow tent. They'll sort you out on the beach.
There's front. A tent.
Just got every man and his dog getting stung, and we're just so busy watching the water that we just can't attend to every blue bottle sting.
All right, so it's a blue bottle. It's extremely common along here, and it's going to be really sore for the next 40 minutes. This will make it feel a load better. Just got to tough it out. You'll be fine, trust me. You see this all the time.
All right, boys. It'll go away. It only lasts about half an hour. Then it'll itch, and then you'll die.
TLC is often enough to ease the pain.
Just want a shower. You just got to tough it out. Yeah. Be strong, mate.
But some won't be comforted.
No! Ouch! No!
You sore? You better off? You're going to be okay? After an hour, you're not going to know anything.
10-year-old Jasmine has multiple stings.
What am I going to do? Go over here and wash the area and then come back in and I'll spray it and give you some ice.
What is this?
And then knock on the door, I'll be right with you.
Oh,
mate, I've seen some blue bottle reactions in my life and that's number one. That was unbelievable.
Jasmine's reaction is extreme. Lifeguards are about to find out why. A blue bottle sting has provoked a dramatic reaction from Jasmine. Her mother has just revealed to lifeguards why her daughter's reaction is so extreme.
Yeah, I feel bad because, the poor girl came over here. We thought she was just overreacting to a bluey sting. It was a horrible sting, but it turns out she's autistic. She isn't overreacting. She just doesn't know why that she's got so much pain.
A topical spray will help further ease Jasmine's pain.
Sit here. Come on, sit down here.
I haven't got one in the head anymore.
No. It's gone.
It just stings for a little bit.
You're gonna be fine.
That was very intense. Very, very intense. At first we just thought it was someone overreacting to a blue bottle, which happens a lot. You get it with grown men, little kids, whatever. Everyone reacts differently. A lot of people don't have much ticker. It shakes you up though, when you see someone in your face that distraught. Pretty heavy.
Half an hour later, calm finally returns. The swelling has almost gone, but not the memory.
I did see the sign, but to be honest, I thought, because where there's so many people out in the sea, that there weren't going to be any about. I don't know if she'll be too keen to go back in the sea.
Luckily, there's no jellyfish on the sand. Ask me,
was it cruel? Having fun has its risks. But lifeguards never know when a real disaster may strike.
Guys, we've got someone pulled out of the water unconscious. I think the IRB jump off.
A man has been dragged from the surf. Within moments, lifeguards make a diagnosis.
I think it's just a suspected spinal. So the boys are just going to run back up here and grab the spinal board and some equipment and head back down.
Dean attends Leo, a 28-year-old Brazilian man. He's unable to move his arms or legs.
No, tell him to keep his head still, very important.
And did he dive in the water?
I didn't see.
Oh, okay, right. And how did he get pulled out of the water? Did you see that?
The boys took him
out. They just dragged him out?
It appears there was just one witness.
Tried to go for a swim. He hit his head on the ground.
Yeah. Right away. Can you feel this now? That's it, you, Sebastian? Can you move his feet? Okay, move it up, Andy. It's okay. I'll meet you. Can you take it off?
Leo is part of a Brazilian dance troupe. He is due to perform tonight.
Let's just leave him. Just like that. Just relax. Is he all right?
Yeah. Está de boa? Tell him he's doing well.
Está de boa, está indo bem.
Just relax. Deep breaths. We know it hurts. Got to be brave.
Jake, I haven't touched the patient as of yet because he's got no movement or feeling. I'm reluctant to do so, but maybe they can advise whether they want me to package him up or not.
Dean hasn't packaged him because he said he's got no movement.
So he's got no feeling at all.
Oi, respira devagar, porque você tá pegando oxigênio, brother. Você não precisa respirar tanto não, porque o oxigênio tá te ajudando, tá respirando pra você. Só tente respirar devagarzinho.
Must be some big problem with this breathing.
In extreme cases, spinal victims can lose the power to breathe.
I just hopped off the phone with the ambulance. They're about 6 minutes off.
Well, maybe,
if Leo stops breathing, lifeguards will be faced with a terrible dilemma. Resuscitating Leo may damage his spinal cord further.
You know, we need an ambulance here ASAP, mate.
Brazilian dancer Leo slammed head first into a sandbank. He has no feeling in his arms or legs. Now, he's struggling to breathe.
Sir, to Dean, the ambulance is coming around the roundabout now. G'day, mate. How are you? What language does he speak? Portuguese. Okay. Oxygen is good. His respiration is good. No se afobe não, tudo de boa.
Squeeze my hand, Leo.
We went for a swim. He can't feel anything, man.
How did he get out of the water?
We pulled him out.
Right. Did he walk at all or move his arms or legs?
No.
Not at all?
He couldn't move anything.
Right? Yeah. Okay.
His chest, it hurts.
His leg and his chest.
So he can feel his chest? Anything else? Any pain down his tummy?
Vou colocar doendo? E aqui na frente? Tá sentindo aqui? Não? Nada?
He can't feel anything.
Tell him to move his feet.
He can't move anything.
Reedy, you're gonna get a chopper.
A spinal board will immobilise Leo on the way to hospital.
One, two, three,
what about
that? Tell him we know it feels horrible. It is awful to have something across your chest. We need to do this to keep him until he's resigned safe.
Ela colocou um pano no seu braço. Já tá em cima da prancha já.
We're going to look at Mark's Park, we're going to transport him up to the ambulance, and then from there coordinate a landing area.
was really upsetting for me to see. He had no movement or feeling below the neck, really. You know, I just kept in there basically and tried to really reassure him, and I wanted to do everything, you know, as much as possible to give him every chance to walk again.
A chopper is the smoothest way to transport Leo to hospital. The only hope is that Leo's symptoms are caused by severe swelling and not an irreparable break.
Touching him and he just had nothing. She was poking him here and he could feel that at the end, but...
That's so sad.
Lifeguards wait for news on Leo's condition. Next day, and there's a happy discovery on the beach.
How are you?
Good.
Yesterday, you got the worst blue bottle sting I've ever seen in my whole life. Emma, did it hurt? So much, hey. Yeah, you scared us. It was the scariest blue bottle sting I've ever seen. I was just telling Jasmine she's the toughest girl I've ever met.
She's worst been a sting. Very brave girl.
Brave and tough as nails.
Are you going to show everyone, though, that you're a brave girl and you can come back in the water now?
Yeah.
Come in the water with me. Come on, then.
Yeah. What a legend.
I thought you have to go back in the water, because otherwise we're here for 5 weeks.
Right.
So if she doesn't get overcome her fear to get in the water now,
she'll miss out on the
day. Yeah, bless her.
Now Jasmine's painful experience is about to come in very handy.
You got stung by a jellyfish? Oh, really? Oh, Jasmine got stung yesterday.
Did she get stung by a jellyfish?
Yeah.
When?
Yeah. It hurts, huh?
When did she do it?
Hurts a lot?
When did she do it?
Just got there. I was getting into the water.
How long did the pain last?
I don't know. Not long.
Not long?
Nah.
Half an hour?
Yeah.
Half an hour. Happy ending for Jasmine. Happy ending for all of us. So, yeah, she can go on in Australia and just have a good time. By coming back down the beach, she's getting back on the horse, you know. Full props to you, Jasmine.
In the tower, word comes through on Leo, the young Brazilian with no feeling in his arms or legs.
Bondo police rang.
Yeah.
And they said that guy yesterday for the spinal.
Yep.
He's quad.
Quadriplegic?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He just called to say, like, to let us know.
Whew. That's terrible.
It's been a week since 28-year-old Brazilian dancer Leo dived headfirst into a sandbank.
He can't feel anything.
Tell him to move his feet.
He can't.
He was left with no movement in his arms or legs. Now, his friends have come to visit lifeguards in the tower.
What actually happened, Timmy?
He jumped for dive and it wasn't dead. The accident was actually after he started to dive.
And then
he's in there.
Yeah.
Like,
oh, okay. Yeah.
We decided to go for a swim. We went for a run to dive into the water. And I just realized that as we swim, we will go up and start to walk back. On the look back, he's still under the water. One of the boys tried to pick him up. And he's realized that he wouldn't come.
Yeah.
So then he turned him around and he was like struggling to breathe. And it was such a beautiful day. It was so funny because we got up. I got up and I went to their house. And we got there, we make breakfast and we feel positive. Like, let's go for a big workout. Let's go to the beach. And our vibe, our energy was so good that day.
What I wanted to ask was, what's Leandro's future prospects? Like, where is it at?
a 1% chance of his recovery ever being able to move his arms or legs again. But they also did say to us that there was the same slim chance of him being able to recover his breathing, which he has. He's completely breathing on his own.
That's awesome.
He has recovered incredibly rapidly in that respect. So, you know, we have hope. But obviously it's going to be a long-term recovery process, treatment, rehabilitation, care. So there's a lot of costs involved.
It's really hard for us to go to the hospital and see him, because when we get there, he keep looking at us. He keep telling me how good I look. And he keep asking me to buy him some protein shake, like supplements.
Yeah.
Like, he's believing his mind that he's going to be okay soon. He's a very spiritual, positive person.
It's very sad. It's one of probably the worst things I've had to deal with in my lifeguarding career. He's such a beautiful big guy.
Yeah.
And I knew. And it was just... And he knew. I could see him on the beach. He had these tears in his eyes. It was just...
Yeah, one thing, it does definitely give you the biggest wake-up call, and you feel like I can... Every single step I take, I should be thankful for. The fact that I can scratch my eye if it's itching. You know, you just got to give thanks for every single moment that we're healthy.
To donate to Leo's appeal, visit the Bondi Rescue website. Next time on Bondi Rescue, Detective H spots some unwelcome guests.
It was like 90% sure she just picked the bag up.
A rescue victim who's drunk a lot more than water and surfs up in Hawaii. Bondi's best on exchange.
You definitely have to have your balls about you to be a lifeguard here, man.
Learning the tricks of the trade from the best in the business.